What's up, y'all? Here with a recap video for last night's fight for the WBA Super World Welterweight title between the champion Yordanis Ugas and the legend Manny Pacquiao. Now, if y'all tapping into this video, y'all already know the results from the fight. Yordanis Ugas was able to retain his WBA Super World Welterweight title and defeat the legend. Now, all three judges had it in favor of Yordanis Ugas, rightfully so. The right man won the fight. There was no robbery involved. And, yeah, Ugas retained, man. And he fought an incredibly brilliant, well-planned-out fight. And I had to fight personally in favor of Ugas as well. I had to fight score 116 to 112. 8 rounds were Ugas, 4 rounds were Pacquiao. Now, without any further ado, let's get into the in-depth analysis of the fight. Earlier on, Manny Pacquiao, you know, he came off from the corner as soon as the bell rung, aggressive and ready to work, and he tried to go on the attack and find his rhythm from round one. However, though, Ugas, he was able to utilize his reach advantage all throughout the fight, and he was pumping that long-range jab all night, and it was working wonders for him. It was finding its mark, just like his straight right hand, and that was able to neutralize Pacquiao's aggression and disrupt his flow and rhythm throughout the fight. Pacquiao was trying to, you know, get on the offensive and, you know, get his combos off. But that jab, man, and that counter straight right, Ugas was counterpunching Pacquiao all night long. Anytime Pacquiao tried to get in range and, you know, start throwing combinations and flurry of punches, Ugas not only would do a good job at blocking and defending against Pacquiao's combos, but he was timing Pacquiao very well and counterpunching him anytime Pacquiao seemed to get in a comfortable range to try and get his combos off. But Ugas would slip in his counterpunches, and that would disrupt Pacquiao's flow all throughout the fight. Those punches, those jabs, that was finding its mark along with his straight right hand. And I was saying in the prediction video, the best weapon for Ugas is that 1-2. And, you know, he would time that 1-2 very well. Anytime there would be a little break in the midst of Pacquiao's flurry of punches, he would just slip in either the jab or that straight right to disrupt Pacquiao's offense. And yeah, man, unlike the Sean Porter fight, he didn't take his foot off the gas pedal. He was consistent all throughout the fight, and I was also impressed with his body work as well. There was a lot of times Pacquiao would complain and the referee would actually step in and say, oh yeah, keep the punches up. But I think most of those punches were legal and on the belt buckle. And, you know, Pacquiao's belt buckle was kind of high. So, yeah, I was impressed by his selection of punches. I'm talking about Ugas and his body work as well. That was kind of slept on throughout the fight. But overall, Ugas, I think, had a brilliant performance in this fight. Now, does this mean Ugas catapults into superstardom? I don't think so. I think he will get recognized as, you know, the man who possibly retired Manny Pacquiao and, you know, gave him his final fight and actually won that fight. And I have Ugas, you know, fighting Errol Spence next, most likely, because, you know, I don't think Pacquiao is going to come back to the sport. He has, you know, other projects to work on outside of boxing. He's been boxing for, you know, almost 3 decades, 20 plus years. This man's been boxing professionally. And with that being said, he has nothing to prove. He's the only 8th divisional world champion in boxing history. You know, this man, you know, has got an incredible resume. You know, he's highly successful. He doesn't need to be in the sport anymore. He's fought everyone throughout his career, any and everyone that he could fight. And yeah, man, I think it's time to, step off and, be a family man and, focus on his presidency campaign back in the Philippines. And yeah, and whatever other ventures that he wants to work on, I think he should focus on that rather than boxing. I think this was just, him, testing himself and, putting on for his fans. And now, man, I think, this was like a passing of the torch. And I hate to say it, if Ugas was able to, beat Pacquiao cleanly like he did last night, I think Errol Spence would beat Pacquiao by a much wider margin. If the original planned fight, which was Errol Spence against Manny Pacquiao, it would have been nastier for Pacquiao, in my opinion. Now, I think as far as Ugas, like I said, he should fight Errol Spence next. I know Errol Spence was keeping a close eye for this fight, as like I said, he was supposed to be the one in there with Manny Pacquiao. I know he's probably disappointed that he couldn't be the one to retire Manny Pacquiao and have the greatest fighter of the 2010s, arguably, the best name, definitely the most recognizable name. It would have been on Errol Spence's resume. But yeah, Ugas got that, and yeah, man. I say, unify three of the four major titles, and I'm pretty sure when Ugas steps in there with Errol Spence sometime next year, whenever Spence is ready to return to action, I'm sure they'll have the Ring Magazine title on the line as well for that fight. And yeah, we'll just see how this welterweight mix goes about. Congratulations to Jordanes Ugas on a brilliant performance and that well-deserved victory. And yeah, like I said, he's gonna get more recognition for having that last fight against Pacquiao and giving him that L. And yeah, let me know what y'all thoughts are for last night's fight in the comment section below. Subscribe if you like, share and rate, and y'all take it easy, stay healthy, be safe, peace.